morning.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, Tanisha, I'm going to take your interview. Are you ready for that?
I'm excited. Yes, I'm ready.
I think it's your 7th or 8th video.
Yeah.
Okay, how do you feel when you come in front of the camera?
I feel really nice and I'm always full of energy whenever I come in front of camera.
How did you feel when you first faced the interview?
Sir, I don't know whether you remember, I cried when it was the first interview. I actually cried.
You actually cried. Now yeah. You feel confident?
Of course. It's like, no, camera is there, but still we have to talk normally. It's not difficult.
That's brilliant. This is the next level of communication.
Yeah.
What do you do to improve your communication skills?
I come to Grandmasters and there Rahul sir is brilliant orator and you know communicator, so I like you are my mentor and you, because of that only I also watch some YouTubers like who are really
what is your aim? Do you want to do something related to communication?
Yeah, I want
because
to
we have seen you developing so good. You have elevated your level of communication skills.
Yeah.
Where do you want you to
I
take yourself?
I want to become a journalist.
Journalist.
And I know that this is the 8th or 7th video and every time my aim is different. But this is the aim which is perfect now. Because that's my passion and I want to go with my passion.
Okay. Do you think that you will be ever bored while you know talking in front of
Never.
Others?
Never. If you see me, you talk for 24 hours. I talk constantly.
Means that job suits you.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's talk about the people who are struggling to improve their communication skills. What do you want to suggest to them?
I just want to suggest to them, just never mind. Like it was like. Yesterday only there was our annual and there was one Didi. She was my, she was with me only in anchoring and she was really nervous. She was like, there is SSP of Khanna as well as principal and all the management members. And I was like, don't worry, they are human beings only like us. We
okay,
are
gonna, great.
And we just give you 100%. The next thing is upon the second person who is
Why
watching.
Why most of the people are afraid of audience?
I don't know, like, cause I have never been afraid of audience. First of all, my mom is like really, really, energetic and really frank. And she, because I have with my mom only, so she was my role model. And she told me every time that always be confident, always give you 100%. And the next thing is upon the person. And you know, the way of your talking matters a lot. You have to impress the person in front of you by your talking, not with your good looks or anything.
Do you think it is important to prepare your topic well before going to a stage?
Yeah, it is.
Because there are some people who are very good in communication without preparation. They go and they speak wonderful.
That's a different thing. Like people like you can go without preparation also. But people who are beginners, they need to, you know, make some points, but I don't suggest them doing totally cramming or rote learning.
So what do you do in that case when you need to handle the stage?
I just make some points like this. I have to speak and I have to speak on this one, but I never learn. I actually cannot learn.
Means if you learn, you will make mistake.
Yeah.
And when
we learn, if we forget something, we get confused. What can we replace? But when we are talking like normally, then we don't know. Like whatever comes in our mind, we just have to speak. So that's easy.
According to you, what we should do to gain a lot of knowledge?
We should just grab knowledge and we should be always in our senses.
Mm-hmm.
Like, because knowledge is something which can come from anywhere.
Can you example something for in students' life from where the knowledge flows?
First of all, I just want to say that a student life is like a life of an army person.
Mm-hmm.
We have to be always, always in proper discipline and always be not distracted by things. And if we'll not get distracted, we will be always focused on our goals. Then, of course, we will get knowledge from everywhere.
As you said, student life is the life of an army person. And, army person sacrifices a lot and he or she, whatever we call, he stays away from family and his dreams are more important to provide safety to the country.
Yeah.
And to be in discipline for that, he has to follow a rigorous timetable. So I think you're true at some extent because in students' life as well, there is a rigorous timetable.
Yeah.
But most of us, we are incapable to follow that timetable. We do make but we are incapable. So what do you want to suggest that how we can follow the timetable that we set?
First of all, we should make the to-do list. Like nowadays, our parents want us to learn everything. Like my mom wanted me to learn karate, so I'm learning. But like there should be timetable that after coming home, I have to, you know, take a nap and then wake up and then do all the homework and then go to karate class and just come back home and, you know, do your hobbies. Like mine hobbies, reading books.
I got that. But there's some students who I have interviewed earlier as well. They complain that doing same kind of things bring the boredom in their life.
So they
break their timetable and they enjoy.
We can make some changes in the timetable. Like we should have some days in the week that in which we can play a bit more rather than doing a bit studies more. Or there are some days in schools also when we get less homework. So those are days are, from my opinion, those are enough. Because as I told earlier, a student life is like army person.
All right, so let's talk about confidence. Most of the youngsters, especially teenagers, they are suffering from any self-acceptance. They don't want to accept themselves, rather they follow others, they want to copy others. What do you want to say about it?
I just want to say that they should have trust in them. First of all,
how to create that trust? Because they themselves feel that their friends are more superior. They follow singers, they follow actors.
First of all, our role models never should be singers or actors. There should be a person who is capable of being a role model. Those singers and actors are just, they're not at all. They cannot be our role models.
In what sense you want to say so?
Because they're not having the, like, some people get attracted to them because of their role in the movie. But we forget one thing, that role is just real. They are not real in the movie.
Oh wow, that's wonderful.
Yeah.
So means that we should differentiate two different aspects of life. One is in front of the camera, another one is behind the camera.
Yeah.
Okay, great that. And on the other side, like most of us, we follow singers. A lot, and we feel that they are the role models. And do you think that singers, sportsmen, as well as these celebrities who act, they should be the role model of today's
youngsters? That's a different thing. If a person wants to go in the stream of singing or a sports only, then we can have them as a role model. But if our aim is totally different, then why to have those people role model rather than the thing in which we are having?
Who is your role model?
My role model is you and my mom, because she is she is so confident and
you can say the daring.
She is very daring. Like
amazing.
Whenever I'm talking to her, I feel like I'm nothing in front of my mom. And in fact, when I'm talking to you, I'm like, I'm doing something wrong because you are such a big orator and
thank you so much for the acknowledgement that you made. Now we move to the next one. That is anger, right? Most of us, we are suffering with this big anger part. So now, what do you think, what brings anger in us?
Yeah, nowadays youngsters and in fact students are very low tempered. They are they get angry very quickly. But
what are the reasons of getting angry? In the past also, we had youngsters and they were sensible.
Yeah.
They used to respect values. But today's youngsters are losing their temperament. Their their nerves get into something. Yeah. What do you think about it?
I think that losing temper is not a good thing. They think that we look cool when we are losing the temper. We look like no one will do. That no one will talk to us and we will be we look cool, basically they think. But why to lose temper? Everyone, if the person in front of us is talking rudely to us or something else, we should be nice to that person so that person may also become nice to us. And if still that person is rude to you, just stop talking to that person.
Love that. All right, let's move to our next topic. That is life, right? And books. So can you describe any book which you have read in last few months?
I have read Who Will Cry When You'll Die.
Okay.
It is
That's
a
interesting book by Robin Sharma.
Yeah, Robin Sharma.
What did you understand from that?
It's having basically a lot of topics, and it tells us about the life, what is life real about. Losing temper and everything, like we should spend time with our family. Like, work is important, but family is the first priority for us. Mm-hmm. And we should give that first priority to our family. And making a, you know, book, like the thoughts we like. And I'm also making that book, a diary. And, you know, talking to yourself. Like, some people think that people who talk to themselves are mad. But they're not mad. You should talk to yourself. You should, you know, say to yourself that, okay, this is your goal and you have to be focused on it.
Oh,
so
yeah.
That a lot of things were told in that book, and that actually changed a lot.
That's wonderful. One last question after the end this interview, Tanisha. How do you improve yourself?
By looking at my mentors and guides, like they are improving, so I am like, I also have to improve. Not the competition, I never do competition with everyone, because my competition is with myself only. Like, this time I'm at this level, I have to go more upper than it, because like the teachers and the parents demand more, because they think that, okay, she's at this level, she can do much better, and that's for my betterment only. So my competition is with myself only.
That's brilliant. We wish you a luminous future, Tanisha.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. It was wonderful talking to you.